Over the last few years, we've seen an explosion of web frameworks written in Python, which make it easy to turn some kind of Python code into a web app without needing to know HTML or JavaScript. I've covered a few of these before, but today I'm going to be talking about one created internally at Google called Mesop. Now, Google built Mesop as a way to stand up web apps quickly for the sake of demos or internal applications. It uses a very high-level declarative paradigm, so you don't need to write HTML, CSS, or JavaScript, just Python. A basic app doesn't take more than a few lines of code to get going. So let's take a look at a couple of basic examples. Now, a simple Hello World page in Mesop requires only a couple of lines of code. Each route that we want to enable for the application we write as a function with the page decorator. Now, this app only has one route, which is the default path, and all that route does is create two objects on a web page, a text label and a button. When we run this code, by the way, we use the Mesop command line to launch it. This is so Mesop can spin up a server to host it. And so when we navigate to the page hosted by the app, we see a text label and a button. Now, let's do something slightly more complex. Let's actually create some elements on a page that have behaviors, some kind of interaction. So in this example, we're going to create an input box and a text label that gets updated when you type in the box. This will also give us a chance to show how stateful operations work in Mesop. The first thing we define is a class that can hold state for our application, and we decorate it with the me.state class object. We only have one thing in it, and that's a string named input. That's the only state that we're tracking across this application. When we define our page handler, the first thing we do there is obtain the state and set it to a local variable, s, so we can work with it. Next, with the text area control, we set a callback for what happens when something is typed in it, and that's the onInput function. You'll notice that in that function, we take a JavaScript-like event parameter, and we also get the application state as we did before, set it to a local variable. And in that, we set state.input to the value of the event, the text that is being typed. And then finally, we have the text label object, and we set the value of that object to the state's input value, so it's automatically updated. Now, this should give you an idea of how state gets passed around and used in the app, and how things like events and callbacks work. So let's run this and see it in action. And what we get is a web page with a text form, and when we type in that form, the text is echoed back in the label below it. Again, all this without writing HTML, CSS, or JS. Let's look at one more example. This shows one of the higher level components that's included with Mesop. A common web app for business use is some kind of chat system, for instance, to allow customers to talk with support. Mesop has a pre-built chat widget, so you don't have to wire one together yourself. Here's an example of how this works. When we create our page, we add to it a component imported from the mesop.labs namespace. It's called chat. And the main parameter that you need to set is the name of a callback function. And this callback takes two parameters. One is the input supplied by the user at any given time, and the other is the history of the chat up to that point. Our chat widget, by default, will just echo back, "you said," and then whatever the user posted. But in this case, if the word poem or poetry appears, it randomly generates a few lines of poetry. So if we run this, we'll get a chat interface, and if we type, we get our message echoed back to us. But if we ask for a poem, we will get one, sort of. Now, again, we could hook up the transform function to any number of other things. We could use it to access an API that connects to a language model or to a system to send messages and receive messages to a support person. But the basic layout and the mechanisms for getting messages and returning replies and also inspecting the state of the conversation up to that point, these are all handled for us at a very high level. All we have to worry about is taking care of input and output. Now, Mesop is not an official Google product in the way that Google Docs or Gmail is. It has no support. It's open source under the Apache license, and it is getting regular updates, though. And the high-level widget collection included with it it's not very large. The chat widget I showed off is one of the most significant of the bunch. But you can build your own widgets, and you can dig into the source for the existing widgets to see how they are implemented. So I recommend giving Mesop a spin if you need to quickly put together a web-based interface for a Python app that fits a few of these common behavioral paradigms. That's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and infoworld.com.